This is Jedi General Pongkrail. I welcome you to the Voice of the Republic podcast. Listen to this podcast. That is an order.
Your reputation precedes you, General. The reputation of a great new podcast.
Hello, and welcome to the Voice of the Republic podcast. This is Bonnie Peace, Beru from Star Wars.
Time to see who's smart enough to join the hunt. The hunt for the Voice of the Republic podcast.
Hello, Star Wars fans across the galaxy. Welcome to the Voice of the Republic podcast. My name is Daniel, and joining me is my fellow host, Rari Williamson.
Nice stutter there, mate.
It had to happen tonight, didn't it?
Yeah, at least we have a different introduction this week, thanks to that stutter.
Yeah, that changes a bit. It's the stutter podcast. Then would you like to introduce our guest today?
We have Gina of the Swag 77 podcast. How are you, Gina?
Hello.
Hello.
Was that lag or just a long time to reply?
I didn't know I was supposed to reply. Hello.
Hello.
You can hear what you're saying, Steph.
She can't hear anything. We can hear you if that's any consolation.
Is she got her headphones or whatever plugged in? You know, just a right. If I'm sure we'll get this fixed shortly, folks. I think speaks something that this has happened, definitely.
Yeah. And there's the popcorn.
Well, hopefully this will be sorted shortly. God, I was on eBay today and I'm still shocked about seeing that in £400. Jabba the Hutt sideshow. I'm just like, wow, that's expensive.
Yeah.
I mean, I looked at one in like .com, an American site, and it was like only like £100, and I'm like, you saved almost £300 on something.
Yeah.
Any reply from Stephanie? Oh, everything happens tonight, doesn't it? Escape doesn't work, and then
Oi, Daniel, you're not the one who had to try and find a replacement guest. FYI, Gina, you were like the seventh person I asked. like Kyle Winner of the Star Wars talk show, like, he was meant to come on, and with like an hour and a half to go before he recorded, he was like, can't make it, work came up. And so I like went on a mad goose chase trying to find someone.
I mean, you tried everybody.
If I tried everybody, there would be 611 people.
Okay.
Actually, 610, not including Kyle.
You tried a few people then.
Yeah.
So still no word from Stephanie?
Hello, can you hear me?
Oh, you?
Yes,
can hear.
We can.
Yeah. Oh, right, yeah, I'm waiting for you to start.
Oh. okay, if you'd like to introduce her then, Rafi.
Well, I would, but now I need to get rid of Facebook. Anyway, we also have Stephanie English, who played a rebel technician on Hoth in The Empire Strikes Back. So, how are you doing?
Hello?
Hello?
Does that like got lost the connection then, but it's alright. As long as we can still hear you, still hear me, I can still hear you, I think.
Yeah, I can still hear you.
Alright, it just suddenly went quiet.
Yeah, that was Daniel. You can tell because the popcorn sound disappeared.
Alright.
Yeah,
it's so, tasty.
Okay. So, Daniel, you want to take it from here?
Yeah, okay. So, hi there, Stephanie.
Hi there.
So, I've got a question for you. My question is, in your experience and memories, what was it like being part of Star Wars and being on the sets?
Brilliant. We didn't realise, obviously, at the time that it was going to be the success that it has been. But it was a, you know, great experience and a lot of fun to work on.
Yeah. And Rory?
My first question is, what was the best part of your experience in working on Star Wars?
I think seeing the set, which was really amazing, and also I was there when they tested out the Tauntaun, and that was really good. That was really fun to watch that. And they were making, you know, checking out that it worked properly and everything.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. And my second question is, what was it like working with some of the cast who had already been in the original movie, A New Hope? Was it difficult to fit in at first?
No, not really. No, it didn't, you know, make any difference, really. You know, just got on with it. I've worked on a lot of films, so it didn't really, I didn't realise, as most of us didn't at the time, that it was really going to be anything different to any other job that we've done.
Yeah, and that actually reminds me, your comment there about something I once heard Jeremy Bullock, Boba Fett, say in an interview, and I was like, he said that when he came back for his brief role in Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith, that like he felt it was no different really from working on the original trilogy, even though there was like a whole new cast around. But like he just felt the whole design, the Star Wars sets and all were the same, that sort of thing.
Yeah, I guess it was probably the same for me, but like, I didn't work on any of the others, so it was a new experience for me. I didn't, you know, I hadn't seen the other sets or anything, so it was all new to me when I did it, but I didn't know at the time that it was going to be anything, you know, outstanding.
Yeah. And then, Gina, have you got any questions?
Well, I'm the ugly American, so I hope you don't mind.
My ugly American.
My biggest question that I have for most, from most Star Wars fans is about the female fans. Did I get cut off?
No.
Okay. And so how does it feel like, being one of the strongest female fans that are out there and one of the best parts of the, trilogy, the original trilogy, Empire Strikes Back?
Well, I guess, I don't know really, I've never thought about it like that. I think it's just, you know, just accept it for what it is and think, you know, it's great that there were a lot of us women in it. It's more unusual in those days. They didn't have, in that type of film, they didn't have a lot of women normally. So it was good that they had much, far more women this time and won the lead, you know, and was a strong woman as well, Carrie Fisher. So, you know, that was a good thing.
Great, because that we didn't know anything about that. They don't talk about that kind of stuff.
No, that's true.
All right, so we're on to the next. I guess questions from Facebook.
Right.
Yeah, we have questions from Facebook for you. So, the first question is from David Mozingo, who asks, how good was it to get to work on Empire Strikes Back?
Oh, it was very good, yeah. It was a great experience, and, you know, I was really pleased to get a part in that. You know, as I say, didn't realize it was going to be as great as it turned out, but, you know, it was still part of a very, you know, famous trilogy that, you know, to work on there.
Yeah, definitely. And also we have another one from David Grimelian, who asks, how much time did you spend on the set itself shooting, and was it all one take or multiple takes?
Oh no, it was multiple takes. I think we're on it for about, I can't remember, maybe I think a week or a week and a half. Well, it was quite a few takes. I mean, we did love other scenes as well. We weren't just setting, you know, the control. We, you know, did scenes where we were, you know, running sort of like through the set and things like that.
Yeah. And our last Facebook question for you is from Zach Ginkle, who asks, did you meet Carrie Fisher?
Yes, I did, but I mean, I didn't have any long conversations with her, but I did meet her, and, you know, I saw her on the set every day that we were there. But I, as I say, you know, I met her, but that was about it. I didn't just say, then I, you know, say hello to her, but nothing else, really.
Mm, interesting. And Rari, would you like to ask anything else? Rari?
He's falling asleep.
We will. Don't see a boss. The other. Oh, he's back.
What did I miss?
I was seeing if you had any more questions, but you weren't answering.
I'm sorry, what? And by the way, Daniel, I just asked you a question.
Did you?
Yeah, I said, I'm sorry, what? Oh. I don't have any more questions.
Do you have any more questions you'd like to ask, Gina?
Oh, any tidbits for people who want to get on, be casted in the new Star Wars Episode 7?
No, I mean, I can't give people, I have no idea. It just depends on who, you know, what the casting director, what agency wants to use and what type of people he wants. So, you know, I have no idea.
All right.
Yeah, so I think it's also what...
wait a minute, Stephanie, Daniel has an additional question for you.
Oh, good, okay.
Obviously, your role in Star Wars, you played the technician, and I see that your technician didn't have a name. Did you put a name to it, or let the fans put a name to it?
I wait for the fans to do it, I think. People have been given names later in now, but to my knowledge, I haven't been given one yet, but I wait for the fans to think of one. The thing is, they've all got to think of the same one.
Well, hopefully after this podcast, maybe some people might send in suggestions or ideas. And
we're good, yeah. That's right. Someone can vote. I won't be the one. I'll let them decide, and they can have someone can decide what name they like best.
Yeah, thanks. So, nothing else, Rari?
Not at the moment.
Not at the moment. Does it mean you might think of one, like, tomorrow?
Well, now that you mention it, Saturday's my lucky day.
Is it?
Well, Friday kind of is, but I have school before, so not all that lucky.
I managed to get the day off today.
I could say something, but I don't want to.
Yeah,
What?! What do you want to say? Just say it.
We're not allowed bad words. Oh no, wait, it's after 9 o'clock. We are allowed bad words.
Oh, you have a bad word to say.
Don't worry, I'll PM him.
Yeah.
Because Gina, in last week's episode of podcast, we had someone curse for the first time on the podcast. It was so
funny. You have to
funny.
Bleep that out.
Well,
Daniel is too late.
Or you have an adult show like I do. I have a PG-13 rated show. So well, we were talking about 50 Shades.
Oh, God, no.
To see if Obi-Wan had 50 Shades of Grey. That got kind of hot, you know, kind of, you know. Now we might talk about Tom Hiddleston. He's interested in being in Star Wars, and a lot of girls like him, so.
I don't think I have enough water, people.
Thanks for that personal message, Rari.
Yeah, well,
I just forgot we've still got Stephanie here with us.
Yeah, she can respond, you know. Come on the sorority meeting. Join the sorority. We have these lively discussions, be like, oh, wow, well, when did Obi-Wan lose his virginity? Yes, we have those kinds of discussions.
I'm gonna have to make this PG-13.
Never mind that. I'm from a chair.
Usually, people that listen to us every week know that we start saying bad words near the end of the podcast because we're getting tired. But this time, it's already starting at the beginning. Oh God.
Okay. Which ale would you guys decide to drink? Mandalorian, Corellian. Or what was the Alderaanian ale? They have all three. Come on.
Mandalorian.
I'd probably go for Mandalorian as well.
That's just greedy, Daniel. It's mine and mine alone.
Well, they have Netregal that's made like out of like it's a milk ale. That's what they say. I don't know how to make L, so...
I still feel sorry for Stephanie, who's just here probably thinking we're all mad people.
Mad. We are.
Well, okay, yeah, I'll rephrase that. Listening to mad people.
Mad. We are.
Are you just going to repeat that every time I say mad?
Well, I do know that Sam Witwer likes Mandalorian. And so does James Arnold Taylor.
Must be why Maul and Obi-Wan are teaming up or joining Death Watch in Season 5.
Well, you know, if you solve it with ale, I think everyone would be happy, except for the Zabrak. They might not like it.
I think we need
those
to wrap
for us. Those are for us Clone Wars fans, you know. I used to be a major original trilogy fan, and then I met the kids.
I think we need to wrap up the interview section. Because I'm just feeling so bad.
Yeah, I think maybe we should ask Stephanie if she wants to stay for the rest of this mad conversation, or if she wants to go on her way.
I'll say goodnight to you. Thanks all the time.
Apart from having you on the show, which was good, you've made the right choice.
I'm sure.
Because this might get worse and worse.
All right. Okay. Nice to speak to you,
then. It's been good to have you on. Bye.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Oh, she'll probably go to bed thinking, wow, this is a madhouse.
No, Daniel, I'm betting she'll pull a Charlie Ross on me, deleting me after the podcast.
Actually, I wouldn't be surprised, not because it's you, but because of what we've kind of, like, done tonight.
I know, that would make me feel so bad, because only today I finally got up to 99 Skype contacts again.
I mean,
I'm one of the amazing 100.
Didn't Charlie Ross remove you as friend last week?
Yeah, that's the point. He was number 99, and when he removed me, it was down to 98 again.
I can make a false account if you want to make it 99 all the time.
No, it's right.
Why did that kind of rhyme?
No, I don't know.
So that's Stephanie's bit of the podcast done, and now it's probably the Mad Show with Gina.
Yeah. Mad show.
Yes, mad show.
Yeah, well, you put on a Mad Hatter's cap and I'll start smiling like the cat.
You know, Gina, I remember when I was first on the Swag 77 podcast with you and Josh, like, that was just such a mad bag of laughs, that podcast. It was so funny.
That's how we are.
Yeah, it was just so funny.
I'll say anything. I don't care. I believe in freedom of speech. So.
Well, if I'm sad or depressed or whatever one night, I know which podcast to listen to.
Depends on my mood. I have those mood upswings, so, you know. You caught me when I was in a bizarro mood, so.
And we've probably still got an hour of bizarro mood left.
Yeah.
And yet only one topic at the same time.
Oh, yay. I just bought 11 figures on eBay. Yay. Anyway.
What, during the podcast?
No, I just bought my last one during the podcast. Oh. I bought, like, a whole bundle, but they're not actually clones.
What?
You guys are all into the clones?
They're not.
No,
they're not even.
I still cannot keep those guys straight. I don't care what you say. I'm not keeping them straight.
They're not even. They're not.
I don't care. Anyway.
They're not even Clone Wars figures. They're like old figures.
What?
They're How can you tell the difference between the stormtrooper?
Well, it's not even a stormtrooper. I think I'm ill. I didn't buy clone troopers and I bought like Power of the Force figures.
Oh, God.
Huh? Something wrong with me, Rari.
Yes. Right. Highly.
I'm off to the doctor's.
Bit late. I mean, what? 16 or 17 years late by now, mate.
Oh well, it doesn't matter. I've waited this long. I'm sure another 20 or 30 years won't kill me, hopefully.
Yeah, but we'll kill everyone else.
Oh well. Oh well. Life's life.
So it's bad.
Yeah, why have I gone blank? Okay, script.
I was just like remembering something funny.
Definitely can choose to leave if we've done that. Daniel, Rari, and Gina discussed the necessary bond. Is that the latest Clone Wars? Yeah, it is the latest Clone Wars.
Yes.
No, it's not. It's the latest Detours episode.
Oh, okay then.
Oh, okay, yeah, well. I'm looking at this thing that says, should marijuana be legalized? While you're saying that. And then I see, like, Dr. Sheldon Cooper say, I've always listened to myself. It's one of the great joys of my life.
Oh, yeah, that was in the latest Big Bang Theory episode. That was so funny.
Oh, did you watch?
Yeah.
Did you watch Russell Howard last night, Rari?
No, I watched the Big Bang Theory earlier today.
Last night on the Russell Howard Good News Show, and there was it was the guy behind Boba Fett and
Jeremy Bullock. Oh yeah, I heard.
Yeah, that's it. Jeremy Bullock. I couldn't remember his name for a second. I went blank again, even though you mentioned Jeremy Bullock like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, your mind just is bad like that. You have very, very short term memory. In fact, I doubt you even remember anything I just said.
Sorry, what was that again?
Yeah. Point proven.
Oh, this is good. Okay,
Daniel, what is his name?
Jeremy Bullock.
I'm not so sure you said that right.
Jeremy Bullock.
Try it again. we should actually set up a blooper reel.
Jeremy Bullock. This is supposed to happen at the end of the show, not the beginning.
Well, at the end of the show, it's worse, and actually, this is technically the middle.
Are we gonna make it through the whole?
Probably not. Someone's gonna go down at some point.
Another one bites the dust.
Probably gonna be Daniel.
Oh, Lord.
if I fall, I'm the one that's recording this podcast, so then the podcast stops with me.
No, but what if you just fall off the chair? You won't be able to hit the stop record button.
I'm lying on my bed, and the computer's hanging on the edge, so it'll probably fall first.
Yeah, no, you'll fall first. You'll crash into the ground back on your back, and then the computer will smash into your face.
I'm a bit mind. I'm a bit mind bleeped word. Oh god, I can hear somebody typing.
That's me. That's me. Sorry.
It's Rari, since he's always heavily typing.
I'm not talking right now. I'm playing with my people.
What?
Your people?
It's my friend Lydia's speech for my figures. I'm not dirty-minded, I swear. Well, actually, I am.
It's not the point. I'm just staring at them. They're on the shelf.
Changing the little Star Wars movie into more despeckled or something like that?
Say what again?
I see these pictures from Retro, and they're like three different versions. You know, and they get clearer images, I guess. I don't know, more color, vibrancy and color.
What's this for?
I don't know, the movies, they've changed
them to Blu-ray, if I'm correct.
They've done the special edition.
And they've done the special edition, now they're bringing out 3D. Slowly.
Next up is 4D in like 2022 or something, I
bet they won't do 4D until they've brought out the next three films.
That's my point, that's why I said 2022.
Oh, okay. The first one's...
4D? What's 4D? You smell it? Ew.
No, it's just a tiny, tiny episode, not really noticeable change from 3D.
Like, they start using, like, the weapons and actually affects you, and you get, like, cut in half or something.
Yeah, that's hopefully it.
Just, like, send all the people you don't like to the cinema, and they'll get cut in half by lightsabers.
All right, Daniel.
Hey, I'll be an old person by that time. Hey.
Daniel, off you go to the cinema. Bye bye.
Have fun.
Bye.
By the way, I'm just quoting out there, but this is random. An ARC trooper holding a Republic commando blaster.
Meh.
Oh god.
Oh god, I better not start doing meh again.
The meh show.
Yeah, last week it was the Meh Grimillion podcast or something like that.
Yeah.
So we should really talk about the Clone Wars, considering it's one of our subjects and the only subject, and we've still got time to kill. Because if we start the podcast here, it's only been half an hour, and that would be the shortest podcast ever, probably. Well, not shortest podcast.
The first one was like 38 minutes, so yeah, probably would be the shortest.
Well, it'd be hours.
But Daniel, here's the thing I've observed about the recent podcast.
Yes.
We start off with our interview, and then straight after the interview, we go to the banter section where we all have a bag of laughs, and then we do the Clone Wars, and then the other topics.
But,
and if we have two interviews, we have the banter in between both interviews.
Yeah, but just think. Okay, we've got Gina tonight, who's obviously full of laughters. But we might have.
There we go again.
We might have another night who we have somebody as a guest, who's somebody really serious and doesn't really laugh a lot, like
Don't you even think of saying me?
Well, no, because it's a guest, not host.
Exactly my point. I'm not serious either.
I can't think of anybody at the moment.
Of course.
Oh well. Anyway,
you know who I actually think would be of one guest, actually. the guy they had on the Underworld podcast a while ago, Steve Glosson or something, who shouted a lot. Yeah, it was so funny. I remember listening to that podcast and, like, I wasn't even really, like, listening to it. I was just, like, doing a lot of writing for my stop motion, and then he was randomly shouting and I kept jumping up in my seat. It was mad funny. And I need water desperately.
So, I'm trying. Oh, I can't even remember the. Oh, I can't remember the. No, I can't. Yeah, I can't remember the latest episode of The Clone Wars.
What are you talking about?
The Clone Wars. I almost forgot what last week's episode was. It's been so long. It's been a long week. I'm sure it's been a long week for you as well.
2 for 2, I'm on fire.
And I'm sure it's been a fun, laughing, or moody week for Gina.
Nope. Unbelievably no.
She's just trying to restrain herself from all that laughter she wants to unleash.
What can it be tonight? It can be the Giggle Something Talk Show podcast. I mean, I'm sure we'll do something further on, but it'll eventually come up, but it'll be the Giggle Something podcast.
No, I got a good one. How about the Gliggles podcast?
Gliggles podcast.
Giggle Wiggles?
There's that.
Alrighty then.
No, just think about it. It's tickles mixed with giggles equals epic win.
Oh, is that how it works?
Yeah.
Yep.
So
what do we want to discuss, guys?
A necessary bond, please.
Got a bad, the bud of the wood. Wait, what?
That wasn't even funny.
No, I was listening to music that was coming from my window, and it was just like that mad one from American Dad.
Yeah, and
then Peter Griffin.
The pink bird is the word.
Peter Griffin is the best on that. I don't think you're gonna find anything better than that.
Okay, how about we actually discuss the Clone Wars now?
Yeah.
Daniel. Daniel.
Yes.
Daniel.
Come in.
Daniel. Yes. Daniel.
Hello.
Did you hear me knocking?
No, I didn't. I just chose to ignore it.
Yeah, so you did hear it then. You so good out
there. So yeah, what do you want me for?
Oh, I don't know, bow-chicka-bow-wow.
No.
Let's discuss the Clone Wars.
Some younglings do some missions, none of them get killed. The end.
That's a pretty good summary, actually. Well played. That's... I reject that statement.
I like the kids! Wait a minute!
My headphones were unloud!
I like the kitties.
Next time, Gina, you should show a bit louder. Wake up his whole house.
I like the kitties.
Wake up! That's my shout for the night.
You didn't like the kids? You didn't like them at all?
Oh, I did.
Oh, man.
The latest episode of the Clone Wars, It was good. The new vehicle that Grievous was on looked pretty cool. Was it just me, or did I see the Twilight vehicle that we the Anakin thing was like in the side of a mountain?
It was the same model, like same type of ship, but it wasn't the Twilight.
Okay, and there's
they kept saying the Twilight. I was like waiting for that guy Robert Pattinson to show up.
Oh, that Robert Patterson, he wants a role in episode 7.
Yeah, no, they called you all kinds of names if you wanted him in there. Some of them I will not repeat.
I haven't even heard of the guy until he wanted a Rolling Stone.
Next,
I thought I'd heard a lot of the actors who suddenly want roles in Star Wars.
Next week I'm going to actually get a beep button so then you can see, everybody can see all the swear words they want and they'll just be beep, 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 beep.
Talk to Kyle Rinner, yep. He knows how to do the beep words, like beeps like crazy.
Yeah, and he also has the spoiler button and all that.
Because oh my god, I just put a little picture on there and they're like, no, I'm unfriending this page. F-U-F-U-S-T-F-U-S-T-F-D. I was like, wow. it's a joke, okay?
I would have just gone, good day.
they used every curse word they could think of referring to that guy. It's like they did not like him. If they put him in that movie, they were like, he could be Jar Jar. And they're like, no, he can't even be Jar Jar.
And also the Slave One was pretty cool to see again. Even though I'm pretty sure it's changed since we've seen it before in the Clone Wars.
Wow, you don't say.
Every time we see the Slave One, it changes color for some reason.
It's still has to change more as well. I mean, it's still not quite accurate to the original trilogy. I mean, for one obvious thing, the Slave One currently has the logo of Hondo's pirate gang on the front, so that has to go.
Is that really Slave One, or is that...
Oh, it is Slave One. They said it was said after the season 2 finale that when Hondo freed Orisane, like mentioned in Assassin, that he also retrieved Slave One because he liked the ship, so he built one that he preferred, like... So he used the parts to like build a new, well, not a new Slave One, to rebuild it, but in a better color that he liked.
Because it used to be blue, if I'm correct. Like a blue color rather earlier in the Clone Wars.
Now it's like green and red and what color is it?
We can call it the multicolored Slave One.
No need to eventually call it that. I think now is a good time.
Well, we'll call it the Multicolored Slave One because it changes color every time we see it.
And that's the new name for the podcast episode.
The Multicolored Technicolor Slave One? Okay. Because, you know, it's like that song. I don't know if you've ever heard it. It's from MC Chris. And it's Boba Fett has a vet. it's a rap, you know. If you don't like rap, then
that just randomly makes me think of the thing. Did either of you ever see the picture of what Daniel Logan had to sign at Celebration 6?
Oh yeah.
It just makes me randomly think of that. that you mentioned.
Mm-hmm. And, I mean, the latest Clone Wars that we've seen previews for looks pretty cool. That little wee character that I don't know what it's called and I don't know what species it is.
He's called Colonel something Gaston. Mm-hmm. You know what kind of amuses me, though? They, like, said about the character, like, they served the Republic since the Battle of Geonosis. Well, which Battle of Geonosis? One or two?
Good point.
Yeah, I know, huh?
But they obviously mean the first one. Yeah. You gotta see the practical joke out of that. I like the voice acting for the character. Yeah. I think Stan Stanton, who's actually voicing the character, did a pretty good job with that voice.
If you mean it, if you mean...
But to be honest, I don't... I've been really positive about Season 5 so far, but honestly, can't even see it now. I'm probably going to end up hating this first Droid Zerg episode.
I mean,
it just doesn't look good at all, to be honest.
It'd be funny if they made an action figure of that thing. It'd be tiny compared to all the other figures.
If anything, it would be an accessory.
Obviously the Ahsoka came with the little hutlet, it'd probably be that size.
Yeah. I'm losing my voice now. If anything, that Colonel dude should have been included with the 2013 Clone Wars R2-D2 to make that figure
I know they've already made a droid pack, but they might make a Clone Wars droid pack with these droids and then the colonel.
Yeah, maybe. Then it won't be a droids pack, it would be a droids pack with a colonel. Yeah, but anyway, back to secret weapons. I do think it's honestly going to be pretty bad. But, you know, we'll see. I mean, the super tactical droid, like, we're getting a second one there. I'm not too sure what they're going to do with it. He'll probably just feel like he's overused, basically, because can't see him being as good as General Kalani, to be honest. Yeah. He'll probably only be there for the one episode.
But, I mean,
I actually will admit, while I hated for the first preview clip we saw, the one where the Colonel was briefing the droids, I thought that preview was arsey, quite stupid. Well, I mean, I somewhat like the second preview clip. That was because of the power one, really.
I mean,
and Dee Bradley Baker did a great job voicing that character. They said it really.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, looking at the Clone Wars trailer that we got before season 5, and we've hardly seen half of what was in the trailer, so obviously we've still got more exciting episodes to come after this arc.
That's the thing, though. They're, like, hyping up the Maul and Death Watch stuff so much. I mean, let's face it, I was, like, half of the trailer, maybe even a bit more than half.
Probably, like, it's just that they're building it all up to leave that, like, probably the second half of the season or something like that.
Yeah, I don't even know what the heck is going on with the schedule for the episode tonight. If I had to make a guess, we're going to get the droids arc, then we're going to get a month... No, can't go. No, never mind. But, like, I think it's going to be the young... What? No, my head's messed up. But I think it's going to be the droids arc. Then we get our first break of the season, and then we come back and we finally get the Clovis episodes, which have been delayed. I think that's what's going to happen in the end. And then maybe we'll get the more stuff.
And then we get to see Ventress fight Ahsoka.
Yeah, exactly. And that arc is honestly the season finale. I don't see why people keep trying to deny it. I honestly think that Ventress v. Ahsoka is the season finale.
And Ahsoka gets killed,
Yeah, because Ashley
Eckstein...
Yay! Daniel, she can't, because Ashley Eckstein already said she's recorded Ahsoka lines in season 6 anyway. But let me get to a point I want to make. Right now, Secret Weapons is episode 10, and we know this is a 4-pack, so episodes 10, 11, 12, and 13 are going to be the droids arc, obviously, and then I believe the next 3, because we know it's a 3-pack, are the Clovis episodes. That brings us up to 16. Now, we know the more stuff is really going to be a 4-pack on its own, because Revival is pushed up. It's now sort of technically another 3-part arc, which I think will go in there. So now 17, 18, 19, that's where the more stuff is, and then we end with the Ahsoka v. Ventress arc.
Wow. Before they were so scared to do, like, 3-4-part arcs, and now you've got, like, every single thing in the season 5 is just 4-part arcs.
What can I say? I'm amazing. Honestly, I honestly won't be surprised if that's how it turns out, because I can't imagine the Clovis arc being pushed back to the season finale. I can't imagine Maul Death Watch being strapped to the droids arc, so I think it's going to go droids, Clovis, Maul Death Watch, and then the Ahsoka thing, Ventress.
Yeah.
And, I mean, and the Commander Thorn thing, I mean, that honestly could come out any time of the season. In fact, that's probably... If I had to guess, the Commander Thorn story thing is going to be part of the droids arc or the Clovis arc, because it's obviously not part of the Maul arc, and slight spoiler here, because there are no clones in that arc, or at least not making a major role. In the season finale, we're getting shock troopers, who knows, maybe that's actually where Thorn is all along, but it's definitely not in the Maul stuff, that's for sure. I mean, there seems to be, even though, like, there's you could say hardly any stories left, I mean, there's still a lot of things we haven't seen yet. We know there's going to be a Rex 5 kind of story, but not an entire arc. But we don't know where that's going to fit in, so... I don't know. I think I need to keep some breath. I just talked a lot, even for me. But no bragging, and I really do mean it. I think I've got the season worked out to a T now. No bragging involved.
Yep. So, I don't know. I think that the, what is the droid arc called? I forgot, but I think
it's
that they're...
It's called the droid arc.
Yeah, the droid arc. I think it's going to be the droid arc. I think that it's a toss-up between the Clovis and the Maul arc, and yeah, they're going to end with the Asajj and Ahsoka arc. So that will be interesting to see.
Yeah, definitely. And even like since we saw the first trilogy and we didn't, when they were to speculate, or this even then I believe the Ventress v Ahsoka thing would be the season finale. I honestly think that duel is going to be very important for Ahsoka and on her decisions in the show, basically, as a whole. Which is why I think that's perfect for the season finale, no matter what anyone else would say, because I know there are others out there who don't think that should be the finale, but I think it's the perfect choice, in my opinion.
Well, when is Star Wars 13 supposed to be released?
I actually don't know. I thought maybe by the end of this year, but I haven't heard anything about it for
a while. I doubt it'll be until next year. I'm pretty sure it's next year it's coming out.
Yeah. Anyway, while I still have some bit remaining, I might as well give my thoughts on A Necessary Bond. I thought it was a really good episode. I will be honest, like, it's not my favourite of the season. Well, definitely not my favourite of the show or the season, come to think of it. I'd put it maybe as third or fourth. I think Revival and Tipping Points would definitely beat this episode, in my opinion. Maybe Bound for Rescue 2, because I see he was a bit more compelled by the story in Bound for Rescue. Now, A Necessary Bond, it was good. I mean... But I do have a couple of nitpicks actually with A Necessary Bond that didn't really take away from the episode at all. I mean, back in A Test of Strength, we got like a pretty cool Ishi-Tib species alien. Ishi-Tib, if you both didn't know, was alien in Jabba's palace, I think. Basically, like his. Aside from all the weak ways in A Test of Strength, we had this green alien species dude, and like he looked really cool, like his character model was great and all, but like, I mean, he was just there in that episode, and I thought they would bring him back in the last episode, maybe use him a bit more, but like, I don't think he was seen at all in Bane for Rescue, and maybe at best in the background of this episode. So he's kind of like a pointless character, if anything. Yeah, so my other nitpick is this, I mean, while it's great, during this episode, they went back to a season one plot line when Obi-Wan, of course, said the quote to Hondo that Dooku knows where he lives. Like, I think it's great that they went back to that again, but I thought there wasn't enough of it. Like, we got 1 minute when Grievous arrived, and then Hondo's put in chains or in prison in his own boundary, and that was that, really. There was no real comparing storyline or something that they wanted revenge on Hondo for holding Dooku hostage. I don't really think there's enough of that, really, but I don't know. And now I really do need to take a deep breath.
This is probably making up for the last episodes that you've not done Rari's rant.
Yeah, no, neither of those were really rants, but you get the
idea. I get the gist.
Because now I'm almost out of breath.
And Dooku saying, I know where you live. What's he gonna do with 4 eggs at his face or something? Why don't we have any more topics? Why can't Star Wars give out news?
I don't actually think Gina shared her opinions on the necessary.
Oh, yes, it's your turn to share opinions, Gina.
Oh, okay. Well, I liked when Grievous showed up, and it was interesting seeing a drunk
Just come to my country. You'll see them everywhere.
A drunk Onaka. And I think that he flipped him over and said, okay, now give me what I need, and showed him the Count Dooku. Now, I didn't hear it in the earlier season where he had captured Count Dooku, and where Anaka knew that Count Dooku was a Sith. I didn't hear that. That doesn't mean that it wasn't said. It just means that I didn't hear it, and I don't hear astutely. But I'm just shocked, you know, from reading Darth Plagueis and stuff, that a lot of people in Star Wars, Clone Wars know that they're Sith, and they're running around, and they're doing bad things. And I'm like, isn't this a secret, though? You know, and maybe that's why, you know, Palpatine or Darth Sidious is like, you guys shut up, we're over here in the corner trying to do our game, shut up. So that was interesting to see. And then with the little kids running around, you know, they're little kids and they could be annoying, and that was enough to make Onaka pretty mad. And he brought out his, you know, he brought out his vet, you know, driving out the hot car, you know, all spiced up, you know, and he thought, I could drive this around. And he almost took out Grievous with it. And I forgot what the guns that he had on the slave one. And so I was like, wow, you know, this is interesting. So he's going to take them back to where now? And I guess he took them back to the ships, the Republic fleet, or 501 First Fleet, that was conveniently close enough. And then they had this one for all and all for one lightsaber show. So, I mean, as far as an episode, it was cute. It had kids, you know, and I'm amazed because even my husband liked that. Liked the little episode. And that's unusual because he usually doesn't like them. And we're like, oh, okay, whatever. When's the next one?
Tomorrow.
So that's what we think. So I think that there are some anomaly or discrepancies between the entire arc and what it all makes sense and stuff like that. But I mean, if you watch it for pure enjoyment and you don't know anything about anything, then this one could stand alone. That's my thought.
Well, that's fun to listen to.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And my random thought is I'm out of water, damn it. Just throwing that out there.
No, just randomly mm-hmm. throwing that out.
Well, yeah, I didn't want to interrupt Gina, so.
You can interrupt me. It's a conversation,
then,
you know? We have
You made a mistake. It wasn't the 501st. It was the 212th.
No, it was but it was the 501st AT-ATs. That's what she was referring to. I actually just have to say something. They really need to sort that issue out. I mean, back in Kidnapped in Season 4, like, the 212th clones were riding 501st AT-ATs. And that just made me laugh. So, yeah, in Kidnapped in Season 4, Episode 11, 212 clones, including Clone Trooper Boyle, were riding 501st AT-ATs.
I'm kind of mind's bleeped words again.
So that's why I get all confused, because it's like they be mixing them up, and I don't know the difference between all of that. Kid says, I want this, and I'll buy it for him.
What?
Do you think I care?
It's really stupid on this show, though. Sort of. I mean, like, how hard can it be to, like, just retexture a 501st AT-AT to a 212th one, just wherever it's blue, paint orange, where the 501 numbers are, just change it to 212.
And I mean, they probably have, like,
it's that simple.
They probably have, like, the top tech of the state of the art, like, Photoshop and all that, where they can just change it in seconds.
I mean, it's just so crazy, though. I mean, like, we saw Commander Cody on this ship with Obi-Wan at the end of Necessary Bond, then we just randomly see, oh, look, wait, there's a 501st AT-AT's walk going past. Wait, what is this?
Possibly they borrowed the ship, considering his main ship got blown up.
No, but that's like a secondary ship now, the Vigilance or something like
that. Oh, yeah, it's true.
So what kind of ship was it? That's what I don't know.
Venator class Star Destroyer. I'm just going back. I'm just going by what the Lego.
It's exactly the same. It's a Venator class thingy ship.
It's the
same one that the Empire used at the very beginning. So it's the ship that we've all mostly always seen through the movies as well.
Yeah.
Well, how you know you took down one ship in one of the episodes. And then, because they had all those recusant and all those other class shits there with them. I forgot the name. Excuse me. I'm sorry. And so then now they have a new fleet. Where did it come from?
Magic. No, it's the other two ships that were with them.
Oh, were there only two ships in there? I gotta look at that
again. I think
there
was two or three. I'm not sure. Yeah,
so they can only focus on one ship at a time? As many capsule ships they had?
The ship that got blown up by the Separatists was one. I mean, going back to the Clone Wars, it's been a ship that we've always seen in the Clone Wars. It was like, just the ship that we've seen during the whole Clone Wars. And obviously, it was like Obi-Wan's main.
So you're saying Obi-Wan did us a favor by destroying that ship?
No.
Then he gets a new one? Woohoo!
It's a shiny ship.
Shady? It needed to be decommissioned, so I had it destroyed.
Can I just randomly say on that topic, I loved how in the scene where the negotiator ship is being destroyed, they reused some music that I believe was used in the Malevolence sec when the Malevolence was destroying the
planet. Oh yeah, now that you mention that.
Yeah.
Kind of sounded familiar, but I couldn't decide where it was coming up, where it came from.
I finally found what I was looking for. I'll message it to you. Hold on, wait a minute. I'll just put in the messages below. Click that image, and you'll see that I was right, Daniel.
What do you mean?
Yeah. Just click the link and you'll see.
It's 501. He's not 501.
Yeah, exactly. That's my point. In that kidnapped episode, the 212 clones were riding 501st AT-ATs.
They're playing Halo too much.
Or the clone was texture artists are a bit lazy.
Maybe they get confused, so.
Yeah, but they've done it too many times and they've mind fucked us too many times. Excuse my language. I don't care that I said that anymore.
Yeah.
How many reels or how many shots do they really have on that on their whatever film or digital recording? Their frames per second? They got like a million of them or something? They can't catch every million of them.
Yeah, but they could have noticed it before they started doing Kidnapped.
Oh, well. I guess they had considered using the 501 first, and then they're like at the last minute. You know, that's the thing, is that they got writers that don't understand Star Wars. They ain't read a book at all. So we all know that.
That's a good point. But like in the comics, like it wasn't 501st clones. It was specifically clone trooper Waxer who came up to Obi-Wan like Boyle did in Kidnapped. Of course, Waxer died in the previous episode, but like it was specifically Waxer in the comic who went up to Obi-Wan. This time it was Boyle, so it was definitely 212 clones.
Should have got.
I actually just have to say something randomly. Sorry for interrupting, Daniel. Like, they should have probably made the 212 HHs because it would have given Hasbro another excuse to do a lazy repaint or two.
If I was playing Boiler Waxer and I was that scene going up to, like, Tobi-Wan and just ask him, why have we got 501st ships with us? Just like...
No, the question that Cody should have asked Obi-Wan at the end of A Necessary Bond
are
is...
Are you drunk?
Why after almost one full season do we still have 501st ships? Because, like, A Necessary Bond is episode 9 of season 5, Kidnapped was episode 11 of season 4. That's almost exactly one season of it.
All I've got to say is go home, Clone Wars, you're drunk.
Go home, 501st Clones, you don't belong here. That yeah. also works.
Yeah.
The funny thing is, though, as well, in A Necessary Bond, they weren't even 501st clones. They were plain white clones on those ATSTs.
Yeah!
And, like, Dan Grievous was on one of the Facebook groups saying, what was up with the stupid cameo by the 501st clones? And this was before I watched the episode, so I was like, oh, great, the 501st clones are going to show up pointlessly for 1 minute. I watched the episode, and I was like, wait, they're not 501st. Even though they're riding 501st vehicles, they weren't 501st clones. They were just plain white shinies.
Oh, so I think we're kind of running out of stuff to stay now. Stay? Say!
Daniel, can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
You... drunk.
let me just look and see what's in the glass that I've got beside me.
Oh my
God. No, I'm pretty sure it's water.
Oh, I thought it was whiskey for a moment.
Now I remember a few days ago. That was funny. Oh, so
yeah.
don't say we're gonna be wrapping up the episode here.
Well, then we better add in something else that's completely random.
There's nothing else to add.
Welcome to Scotland.
Well, what do you think is the storyline for episode 7?
Sorry to interrupt, Gina. Oh, no, you didn't, Rari.
Oh, yes, I did.
You guys are funny.
I know.
We're funny. You guys are funny.
Oh, sorry. Sorry, what was the question again?
I forgot. Anyway.
It was about episode 7.
Move along.
Yeah. Are you guys even excited over there, or you're like, whatever?
I'm excited for the sequel trilogy. Any other movie that Disney is like to release after those, after every 2 to 3 years afterwards, think about those ones later, but the sequel trilogy, yeah.
I've got nothing to say until I start hearing more about it. That's all I've got to say.
Yeah. Are you guys all the strict, wait till they come out with information and then I'll decide?
Yes.
Yeah, pretty much. Don't want to get my
You guys
hopes
are
up.
Not speculators like I am. Yeah. I love speculating.
Oh no, my battery's running out of computer.
That was a random change.
I didn't even say that right. I said my battery's running out of computer.
Oh my God. Daniel, you've had way too much whiskey.
Right, time to charge my laptop.
Oh, wow.
Okay, that didn't come out right.
Bow chicka bow wow.
Okay. Back to what we were doing.
Bow-chicka-bow-wow.
Keep doing that and I'll stop the podcast. Well, I'll have to obviously shut the podcast down before I stop it, but...
Wah-ha-ha.
So is there any more topics? You know? Or...
Nope.
Or is this going to be one of our shorter episodes tonight? It wasn't really...
There's the popcorn back.
There we go. It was all kind of last minute. I mean, their second guest didn't confirmed tonight, and then we had to find...
And you still don't even know who that big man was.
I know who it is.
And you won't.
I know who it is, Ravi.
Who?
I'm not going to say it here now.
Yeah, do.
No.
Go on. Oh, fine, PM me.
I'll PM you after the show.
Fine.
Oh, so anything else any of you guys would... I know you're, what you're going to say, Rari, so I'm not even going to ask you.
No, Daniel, I need to say something.
Okay, go ahead.
Daniel.
Rari.
That's my spot. Bazinga.
Anything else you'd like to add before we start finishing this podcast up?
I'm your boss now. You may want to laugh at that.
Ha, 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 ha. There we go.
Fake laughs do not count on this podcast.
Okay, in that case, I'll just take it as yes, and we'll start closing the podcast down. So, make sure to check out our YouTube channels. Mine is www.youtube.com/user/14MrDass. Rari's is www.youtube.com/user/separatistdestroyers.
I still swear every time I think you're going to stop and wait for me to say it. Because you always stutter at one point when you're saying you
yeah.
or something.
Check out Gina's Facebook page at www.facebook.com/IGotSwag77 and also Stephanie's Wikipedia profile at www.starwars.wikia.com/wiki/Stephanie.
Daniel, that's Wikipedia, not Wikipedia.
It says Wikipedia.
Yeah, you said Wikipedia.
Oh, and also check out the YouTube of the podcast, which is the Voice of the Republic Podcast 1. Also check out our Facebook if you haven't seen it, but you've probably seen it because you probably found the episode through there. But anyway, www.facebook.com/thevoiceoftherepublicpodcast. So, that's mostly our episode tonight then. Oh, it's been a laugh. And I need to remember not to put the intro with the music from last week.
And you need to remember not to drink so much whiskey in that next week.
That as well. So it was good having you on tonight, Gina.
Yes, thank
bit
you.
Bit of a change, bit of a laugh, which is good once in a while on this podcast.
What are you talking about?
Yeah.
We always have a
I
laugh.
I just went there.
Just sometimes we have even bigger laughs.
Yeah, true. But it was kind of... Sometimes we have laughs, but it's not as long, but it was like every second word tonight was laughing.
Don't even remind me of the time we had Dan Grievous on the podcast.
Oh, God.
That was funny. No, Daniel, I actually have to just randomly say something.
Oh, on you go.
Remember how back in the day some of the people listening to our podcast were complaining that they thought our podcasts were too, like, to script and not enough random stuff. Well, I think we can say that's definitely changed for sure anyway.
The only thing we go by script is the intro and the closing, and that's alright.
The rest is just random stuff.
Yeah, but now we kind of divert fun stuff, not following a script, which is mainly how I lost the first two hosts before you joined.
It was a good thing that you lost.
It was a good job I picked you up because you...
Yeah,
I was going to actually ask a best friend of mine, but he wasn't online, so I thought, well, why not give Rami a chance? It'd be fun to do something with him.
No, that isn't right. That is not how I got the job.
It was, actually.
No, it wasn't. I was messaging you, and you were like, my two co-hosts called out on me, and I was like, and then you were like, no, I was like, too bad or something, and then he was like, I need to look for a new co-host, and I then said, you're talking to him.
Yeah.
No, wow.
Before you said that, I kind of thought of something else, and I thought you would actually be the best option.
Yeah, but you didn't say that.
No, I thought of it.
Yeah, but you can say it. Point.
Anyway, so if you know, also check out what was it? Stop watching series of a friend called Stormtroopers. He sponsors us a bit. We sponsor him a bit, apparently. I had to say that. I kind of agreed to, like, kind of just mentioning his stop motion in the podcast, and then he mentions our podcast in the stop motion, and he gets quite a lot of views, so we get a couple more viewers. So from Stephanie, Gina, Rari, and me, may the force be with you, Star Wars fans.
May the force be with you.
And the
Lord's
time,
don't forget the Lord's time. We won't forget the Lord's time. Until next week, Star Wars fans.